Page 35, the cold shower. They're introducing you to another ornament called a trill. A trill is simply where you alternate between two notes that are next to each other. It could be a whole step or a half step, either one, depending on the piece and the needs, but that's called a trill. Now what it is look at, where do we go? Let's go down to the last line, second measure. In the right hand, you have a G with that TR in the squiggly line. That's the symbol, that's one of the symbols for trill. And it's simply telling you to take that note and the next note in the scale above it. In this case, it's an A. We're in the key of C major. So that it would be an A. And you alternate those two notes. Now, on trills, highly recommend that you do them rhythmically. And they should be controlled and even. They don't necessarily have to be fast. In this case, we're doing 16th notes because they wrote out the trill up above. So, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 4 time. Eighth notes would be 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 and. 16th notes is 1 e-yenda, 2 e-yenda. 1 e-yenda, and that's what these are. Starts with a pickup beat. 2 e-yenda, 1 e-yenda, 2 e-yenda, 1 e-yenda. Like so, and that's the trill. These notes. So for one beat, we trill it. That's what that means. Fingering wise, there's all kinds of fingerings for trills. This fingering is fine for now. I never use it on a short trill, on a four note trill like that. I never use it, but it's good starter. All right, we'll get into the other stuff later. Right now, 2-3 is fine. And then the left hand, you get it. First measure of the second line is here. They've written it out there. If you go down to the bottom line on the third measure, you see the G with the trill above it. That's how it's played. So it's four notes. So to do the last line for you, it's here. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Of course, you play faster than that, but when you're learning it, that's what it is. So say at the top, it's con brio, means with brilliance, whatever that is. Basically, they want you to play it a little faster than that, so the trill sounds faster than that. I recommend you keep it slow on these trills until you get a hang of them. There are a number of YouTube videos, good ones, that teach you how to trill, how to approach it. I recommend you search them out and watch them. Don't just watch one. Watch the others because there's different approaches to how to trill. I'm terrible at it. I always have been. I try, but that's what it is. Some people are better at it than others. Watch those on how to trill. Just keep them slow and controlled. You get them fast later on. So in this piece, it would start out one, let's see, one E and a two E. One E and a two E and a one E and a. So when you take it up a little closer to the speed, it's that. Later. You can take it out of there later. And remember, with trills, the rule is that it is that note given and the next note up above it in the scale. Now, they can introduce accidentals in trills. That's where you'll see sharps or flats above the trill mark. Don't worry about that right now. Just know it's the next note in the scale. If you're in C major, it's like the last note on the second line. You have a C. Well, you're going to, the other note involved is going to be the next note in C major, which in this case is a D, because that's the next note in the scale. So you know. Those are the notes involved in the trill. Keep that in mind. It works all across the board. I mean, that you can count on that. Let's try this out really, really, really super duper slow. Checking the rhythms and the trills here. You want to sing it, you go right ahead. I'm Forget the second thing. Ugh. So I'm going to give us three counts. A full two counts plus one because there's a pickup beat. Go ahead and put your right hand here. Left hand here. There we go. One, two, go, we end up.